Hi guys, I'm Hasterius. To prevent my channel reputation ruined, to protect the peace in the fan community. Like I said, I will make the video top 4 biggest dragon gangs in how to train your dragon. Not so much anymore, let's begin.
1. Grim Nasher. What do you expect from the breath top dragons? Plasma of the Night Fury. As the big with the beast, lightning at the screw. They are diverse, right? And today I will show you a new kind of breath, that is tooth breath. Yes, you did not hear wrong. Grim Nasher belongs to the sharp class. They have serpentine necks with heavily built chests and abdomens, a small head and 4 legs. They have 3 main sets of horns on their heads, complemented by more along their necks and backs. In addition, they have a long nasal horn and a distinct underbite with rows of small, pointed teeth, giving them a sinister appearance. Covered with prominent, iridescent purple scales, they have a paler underbelly but more vibrant coloration on their backs and wings. The Alpha Grim Nasher has purple scales, red stripes on its back and red wings, differentiating itself from the rest of the group. Much like sharks, Nashers have the ability to shed and regenerate as many rows of teeth in their lifetime. They are said to have 1,000 teeth. Furthermore, they can attack by shooting them in their blasts with unmatched accuracy. These tooth blasts can also go quite a distance and deal a good amount of damage. Their remarkable communication skills are the core of their extraordinary teamwork. They are able to plan and communicate to colossus against their prey. As such, they tend to hunt impacts and ambush their prey. Similar to the speech stingers, the Grim Nashers have a leader whose orders they follow. Grim Nashers are very fast and agile dragons that are able to swiftly ambush their prey as well as evading attacks. However, they are not as fast as the strike class dragons. A Grim Nasher is not very strong. They are scheming and cunning predators that tend to plot against their prey. When together, Grim Nashers are very dangerous. Furthermore, they explore the weaknesses of the old and chic dragons of Vanaheim. This behavior is likened to that of hyenas who circle with prey and consume carrion. 2. Cinchertail. Belonging to the stalker class, cinchertails have quite flat body and a long tail. They have 4 wings, like a thunder drum, but with the bigger pair being set lower on its back. They have a spiky face with chameleon-like eyes that allow it to see in multiple directions, as well as several big, sharp spikes along their backs and tails. Cinchertails are able to fly for long distances without showing any signs of exhaustion, while also carrying the extra weights of humans and metal chains. They can receive a continuously beating from a whip without losing any stamina. Cinchertails can take powerful shots from other dragons, such as the Night Fury and the Rumblehorn, without receiving too much damage. When in the air, they can recover easily after being shot and barely unbalanced for a few seconds. Cinchertails are able to fly at great speeds, as they can keep up easily with other fast dragons, such as Night Furies and Deadly Nadirs. Cinchertails are very agile dragons, able to dodge attacks from their foes. Thanks to their double set of wings, cinchertails can do tight turns and easily maneuver through tight places. The cinchertail's eyes can move independently one from the other, which allows the dragon to see two different directions simultaneously. Their eyes can also swivel to the back and sides of their heads, giving them a 360-degree view which resembles that of a chameleon. Cinchertails can shoot fire from not only their mouths, but from their tails and bellies as well. Their stomach fire is achieved due to the gills that line their underbellies. They often use it as a defense from those attacking underneath. As is demonstrated by Krogan's cinchertail, the fire that the cinchertail produces is scarlet in color and can be used to mark their territories or as a signal to call for their reinforcements from its own species. Cinchertails can also use the fire from their belly to temporarily boost their speed like a rocket. The heat from the fire option cinchertail individual, such as Seer. can be felt from 10 feet away, and others, such as Infinia, are able to immediately light on fire any nearby torch, hearth, or furnace with their flames. Altitude. Stylo Jorgensen discovered that cinder-tails cannot fly at high altitudes. This served as a route of escape if being pursued by one. The reason for this is likely due to the fact that the higher up birds go, the denser the air becomes and requires more physical effort to keep flapping their wings. So the cinder-tail with their larger body and double the amount of wings of most dragons and the positioning of their wings may make it harder for them to fly. Fog. Cinder-tails are shown to be very reluctant to fly into a heavy fog in the winds of God, Hawk 1. This is presumably because they cannot see where they are going. Even though other dragons seem to be able to sense their direction, however, this weakness does not seem to affect our cinder-tails. At Grogan, the cinder-tail has no problem flying through the fog. Neck. When their necks are pinching a certain spot, cinder-tails fall asleep. This was shown in Living on the Edge when Grogan subdues an embered cinder-tail. Skrill. In Triple Cross, Vico uses the Skrill to counter the dragon flyer cinder-tails. Knowing that the Skrill is the cinder-tail's natural predator and the Skrill's electric blast can neutralize its fire. Flower Vapor. As mentioned in Stoic description in Dragon's Titan Uprising, a cinder-tail can be put into an inebriated slumber by letting it breathe in a pleasant perfumed vapor, created by slowly cooking fragrant wildflowers with its own body fire. While in this sleep state, cinder-tails are completely harmless, with Vikings being able to approach, touch, or even sleep with their head resting on the dragon with no danger of being attacked.
So part 1 of top 4 biggest dragon games is over. The next video would be part 2 with the other 2 dragon species. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe if you like my video. See you again.